Defense Minister Rajnath Singh chaired a meeting of a group of ministers at his residence today to discuss ways to mitigate the hardships faced by the people and the role ministries can play in providing relief to the people. The ministers discussed restarting economic activity in coronavirus-free zones after April 20th. Piyush Goyal, Prakash Javadekar, Smriti Irani and Dharmendra Pradhan were in attendance, among others. The Indian government notified restrictions in foreign investment by beneficial owner of any country having land border with India. Investment from China, even indirect ones, then will require government approval. The press note stated that this review is for curbing opportunistic takeovers or acquisitions of Indian companies due to current COVID-19 pandemic. This notification comes on the heels of Chinese investment in HDFC Bank, which is India's largest private bank. India's IT and ITES companies can start work with up to 50% strength from April 20th, but there are challenges, and IT company chiefs at a meeting with Karnataka Deputy Chief Minister Ashwath Narayan have listed the same. MD of Biocon, Kiran Mazumdar Shaw, said that companies should arrange buses for employees to eliminate too many private vehicles on roads and also set up screening facilities at offices. IT companies are looking at a phased return for on-site employees. Delhi police has slapped charges of sedition and abetting riots against Sharjeel Imam in connection with the violence in Jamia on 15 December 2019. The police said Sharjeel Imam was arrested based on the charges of instigating and abetting riots in Delhi due to his seditious speech delivered on December 13, 2019. Maulana Saad, the chief of the Islamic group Tablighi Jamaat, has said that he is willing to cooperate with the Delhi police days after he was charged with culpable homicide, not amounting to murder, for holding a gathering last month at the Nizamuddin Markaz. The Tablighi Jamaat congregation has emerged as India's super spreader group. Now, the chief of the missionary group has said that he has already joined the investigation being conducted against him for holding the congregation at the crowded venue in South Delhi, defying all norms of social distancing and advisories against large gatherings. An 85-year-old man in Kerala's Mamallapuram who had recovered from COVID-19 has died. State Health Minister K.K. Shailaja said that his death can't be attributed to the virus, as the man had comorbidities and he was brought for treatment in an exhausted physical condition after suffering from respiratory and heart-related ailments for years. At least 21 Indian Navy personnel serving at the Western Naval Command in Mumbai are feared to have tested positive for coronavirus. The Navy personnel were part of the INS Angre, a logistics and support facility of the Western Naval Command. The sailors have been quarantined at a naval hospital in the city and a massive contact tracing operation is now underway. The Union Home Ministry has asked all states to track down and screen Rohingya Muslim refugees over concerns that they may have come in contact with members of the Tablighi Jamaat. The Indian government estimates that there are around 40,000 Rohingya in camps across the country. The Matterhorn Peak in Switzerland today was lit up with the Indian tricolour in a message of hope, inspiration and solidarity. Prime Minister Narendra Modi shared on Twitter the pictures of the 14,692-foot mountain lit up with the tricolour. Since the past 1 week, every night from sunset, the Matterhorn Peak is splashed with words and images from 4 kilometres away onto the north and east faces of the mountain.